The international police Interpol says the time is now for Nigeria to declare emergency in the area of internet fraud and cybercrime. Head of Nigeria Police Cyber Unit, Interpol National Central Bureau, Abuja, said this at the annual cybersecurity conference for 2020, which was organized by the Nigeria Communications Commission, NCC, in Abuja. Our correspondent, Tunji Oye, now reports.
In this hall are representatives from the international police, the Interpol, Office of the National Security Advisor, the NSA, the EFCC, the Nigeria Intelligence Financial Unit, the NFIU, the Defense Intelligence Agency, the DIA, the Department of State Security, the DSS, the Independent Corrupt Practices Commission, the ICPC, and ECOWAS. The reason for this gathering is not far-fetched. The fastest crime in the world today is cybercrime, and cybercrime transcends borders across the globe. So, there is need for players, regulators in the industry, and security agencies to compare notes and find ways of securing Nigeria's cyberspace.
The government should actually declare state of emergency in this cybercrime issue, because if you watch what is happening now, like for instance, we have over 40,000, 40 million people that have access to internet, to telephone, to smartphone, over 40 million. And there's a projection that by 2025, that the number will increase to 140 million. So that will tell you that we have huge problem. And if you look at the internet penetration now in Nigeria, it's about 134.1 million, that have access to internet. So if there is no adequate funding and for us to, be able to get the required equipment, the required softwares and tools that will help us to tackle this, it's going to be a huge, huge problem in future, because the trend is growing. The number of youths that are coming out from the universities without job is increasing on a daily basis. The access to internet is increasing on a daily basis, and there is need for us to have an urgent measure that will actually help us to curb this menace.
From the submissions of speakers, crime in the society today is no more physical but cyber. But is Nigeria winning the war against cyber crimes and internet fraudsters?
We have Cyber Crime Act 2015, in which the security of telecommunications infrastructure has been categorized as part of critical infrastructure in the country. And this is a clear indication that the federal government of Nigeria has discovered that strengthening the security and resilience of our telecommunications infrastructure is key to our economy and is very critical to the success of our nation as a country. Furthermore, as we all know, on 28 November 2019, Mr. President has unveiled and launched National Digital Economy Policy and Strategy. That policy cannot be implemented without trying to secure our own cyberspace. We need to build confidence to convince Nigerians that government is doing all it can to ensure that the cyberspace is well secured and protected.
The war against cybercrime is one that is continuous, as the level of internet penetration is increasing, the level of cybercrime increases. This is a well-known fact. But the regulator is saying we are doing everything possible, and regulatory-wise too, okay, including putting measures in place that are technical in nature. And here I'm talking about the Cyber Security Incidents Response Team, a network of computers that are arranged together, configured in order to protect our networks, from cyber criminals. On the regulatory end, we will come up with additional regulatory instruments through the instrumentality of the law. We can also provide additional protection. So this is a two-pronged, approach to ensuring the networks are safe for users.
In today's world, cybercrime is at the speed of light, while cybersecurity is at the speed of law. It is therefore important for Nigeria to come up with legislation and policies to fight this borderless scourge called cybercrime. From Abuja, Tunji Oye, TV360 News.